In this video, find out why I think Insta360 is not really in the business of making cameras. Rather, it's an artificial intelligence company in disguise. And why I think this is why they will win the battle of the consumer level 360 action cameras. Check out why I think the Insta360 One R will crush the 80-20 rule, also known as the Pareto Principle, for video production, and why I think this is just the first in a long line of product developments, meaning that they become the brand to beat or buy, either as a consumer, a competing brand, or a brand like Apple looking to leverage artificial intelligence technology that Insta360 have developed into their own products. Hi, my name's Saab Johel, and thanks for joining me on my channel showcasing light and easy mobile video making and gear. If you enjoy this video and get some value from it, please give it a like, drop me a comment, and consider subscribing and even share this video too. Cheers. Yes, the One R was released with much noise and hullabaloo earlier this week. I was away filming down on South Island in New Zealand, so I couldn't respond immediately, but that's a good thing because that gave me a chance to reflect, think, and perhaps offer you a different perspective, a broader strategic perspective than others I've found so far on YouTube. But let me cover the basics first and then build my theory from there. So as we've all seen, the One R takes a modular format. You know this. There are three formats, a 360 format, a 4K format, a crispy looking 1-inch sensor format co-developed with Leica 2. Leica. There may be more in the future. I guess that's the beauty of a modular concept. And all these lenses and sensor modules can all be attached to one core, not all at the same time, which I think is also going to be upgradable over time. Again, when the camera processing is upgraded, you still get to keep your legacy lenses and units. Sweet. The 1-inch sensor is the one that's got my attention, which is also because I think you'll be able to hook two of these together for VR180, which YouTube is thinking might become pretty big. I know they funded people like Jeb and Dobie to go to make VR180 content, and I think they funded other people to do a similar thing too, or other things, but anyway, they're looking at VR180 for sure. So maybe 360 video might be replaced into VR180 videos on YouTube, which they're betting on becoming easier to use and perhaps more engaging on their platform. A double 1-inch sensor would certainly add a heap of quality to that format. Okay, back to the camera. It has a bright, small 360 view capable touch screen that you can use to monitor yourself when vlogging too. And the red base it all attaches to is also the battery, and it looks like you can also have another battery base attached below and potentially stack batteries in the blind spot of the camera when shooting in 360, which is great, but may add a bit of volume and weight if you're mobile. Okay, that's the hardware. As far as the performance goes, it's hard to tell at the moment. I'm hearing that stabilization appears to be improved. Recent developments like Color Plus and True Audio will be included too. And there's also lots of external audio options available now, like AirPods or the Rode Wireless Go, as well as new features like points to track. And in the action camera build, it can do 200 frames per second in 1080p, which is fantastic, as well as a live histogram in 360 video mode too, which is just amazing for being able to control your exposure. And there's lots and lots and lots of other things like deep tracking and auto editing. And I'm not even going to get into the whole drone blender thing, but trust me, I'm aware that this is a problem for many people who feel a tad misled. Now, a load of footage and videos are going to drop on January the 14th, and that's just a few days away. It's embargoed until then at the moment as they finalize stitching and other software improvements, I understand, but I can't wait to see what they're going to show us. Oh, and pity the poor GoPro Max. What with the competitive pricing and the extra features available, just the slow motion and the 60 frames per second and the high resolution footage to name but two, I suspect that sales for this device might take a bit of a hit. So what's the 80-20 rule and why should you care? Let me explain why the development of Insta360's artificial intelligence capability underpins everything that the company is doing now and everything it will do in the future. Let me be clear. I don't think Insta360 is a camera company. Well, not just a camera company. I think it's an AI company in disguise, and I think they're going to attract a lot of interest from the big players, and they already are. Here's why the AI in the Insta360 One R will win. Now, you might have noticed that I'm in the process of a slight rebranding of my channel. It's still about 360, but it's broader than that. It's about showcasing light and easy mobile video gear and editing. And I think Insta360 is pretty much on brand for how I want to do my video and photography. I know how to do it manually, but I'm a busy guy, a husband, a dad to three small kids. I run two YouTube channels. I have a psychology consultancy as well as other businesses. I could spend the time but I haven't got it. So the investment that Insta360 have made in the AI to do the heavy lifting for me is an absolute godsend, and I suspect I won't be alone in thinking this. Insta360's AI can detect where you are, what the conditions are like, what you're trying to film or photograph, and then optimizes those settings for you. Now, you could do this manually, and indeed the One X and Go apps for Insta360 do give you advice on the settings best for what you might want to achieve with the examples they give you on the app. But this in the One R is taking it a step further. It detects the conditions you choose, you say you what you want to track, or what is the main object in the video, perhaps even switching between objects or tracking multiple objects, and the AI sorts it for you. Who needs complicated workflows that soak up hours in time, the most precious commodity we have? Sure, I can improve my photo or video by 10% if I had the time. And for the artisans among us who pour their heart and soul into their work, I totally salute you and admire what you do. I watch your channels and I see your work in galleries, online and in real life. I even pay to go and see it. But in my book, Insta360 are nailing the 80-20 rule. Now, this rule, or observation more accurately, also known as the Pareto Principle, states that roughly 80% of the effects come from 20% of the causes. So let's think about that. If 20% of the input can create 80% of the result, what if the AI that Insta360 executes in their new product can be that 20%? What if it can take much of the laborious heavy lifting out of shooting, object tracking, and post-production editing out of the equation and do it for you, getting you 80% of the way towards your final product? And what's more, that 80% is high quality in terms of video quality, stitching quality, object selection and tracking, color rendition, and audio quality. What if all you had to do was personalize that final 20%? By taking care of the tricky, laborious, time-sucking 80%, Insta360 gets you 4/5 of the way there, leaving you glorious time to shoot more and to add the final gloss to your edits, and you get all the glory. Cheers, Insta360. That's what I think is going to happen. That's what I think is happening. And that's why I think Insta360 are going to dominate the market for people who want stuff that just works, just like people who buy Apple stuff that just works. Okay. Insta360 might have some way to go in terms of the reliability of their products, and I'm afraid that I don't expect them to have as polished an offering on the Android platform either, because I think it's more difficult for them to give a reliable, consistent experience on a platform that varies in so many different ways. But on a lockdown iOS and Mac platform, I think that's where Insta360 will shine with their AI implementation, especially if you've got the processing power in your latest devices to keep up. So the overall ethos of Insta360 currently strikes me as really Apple-esque, not least because Insta360's approach seems quite focused on iOS and Mac users. And that seeming integration seems to be taken to an even deeper level with the ability to use with AirPods. Why hasn't anybody else done that? And how seamlessly it seems to be able to work with Apple devices. And it got me thinking, is Apple going to buy Insta360 in the future? Is this Insta360's exit strategy? Could that happen with a Chinese company? First, let's understand the context in China where Insta360 is based and making these leaps forward in technological implementation of AI. With the launch of the new social credit system in China this year, a lot of resources have been plowed into developing the capability of being able to track people effectively through networked camera systems. I don't think it's too far of a stretch to understand how some of the technological know-how and expertise underlying these developments may also have made their way out into more commercial applications with an export market. I'm not saying that this is what has happened at Insta360, but it's important to understand the context of wider developments in China to understand the technological breakthroughs that are happening. Is it any wonder that AI capabilities of camera tracking systems are showing up in all kinds of Chinese-made technology? Where does this lead to for Insta360? Well, let me speculate in a completely counterintuitive way for a minute here and see what you think. I think it's leading towards a possible exit strategy for the founders of the company. Now, don't get me wrong. I think they make brilliant products. I think they want to grow the company. And I know it seems impossible, a US company buying a Chinese company. But let's follow the breadcrumb trail here. Firstly, The financial statements made on CNBC in March 2019 that I talked about in my video up here, worth watching if you haven't already seen it, said that they had sought and secured funding for developing their artificial intelligence software for future products. What with Flash Cut and the Insta360 Go and now all these additional enhancements for the One R, I think we're starting to see that investment show itself and starting to bear fruit. And I don't think we've seen the end of it yet. I think there is more AI capability to come. I'd love to hear your thoughts on where you think Insta360 is going with their AI capability. What do you think they're going to enable us to do now in our video and photography that they haven't already identified? Secondly, we also know from these statements that they intend to float as a public company sometime in 2020. And I think this is all about getting a market valuation of the company and then starting to realize this value. For me, it looks like their end game is to get bought out, perhaps by Apple. Look at all this integration, or perhaps another big tech company like them. And I think they have developed their AI to be transferable to other applications with exactly that end goal in mind. And I think Apple or other tech companies are getting to know that the AI that Insta360 is developing could help them out with other products too. I mean, who wouldn't want help with tracking and predicting movements or processing high volumes of visual data? Perhaps a manufacturer of autonomous vehicles. Who knows what applications lie in store? And that's why I think Insta360 is actually an artificial intelligence company in disguise. I wonder if a tech company like Apple might buy the company less for their camera products, but more for the AI technology that underlies it. Because that's where Insta360 have heavily invested, doing 80% of the work for you, and you add the personalized 20%. A bit like Apple products too, maybe. I'd love to hear your thoughts on my theory. Let's get some debate happening down in the comment section to this video. Get typing and let me know what you think. Hey, thanks for watching. Remember to like the video if you liked it. Share the video if you think other people might want to see it, and subscribe for more videos and click notifications so you know when I've posted more. Check out my other videos on my channel, and thanks again for watching. Cheers and go well.